There's a deer. About 50 feet to my right. It's just staring at me. I don't want to scare it. About 50 yards in front of me, there is a deer. Morning, everybody. I am out enjoying this beautiful fall morning, end of October. It's about 40 degrees, sun's out, it's a little breezy. You can see behind me the leaves are still hanging on some of the trees. The oaks and the birches still have some leaves. I came out in the middle of a field this morning trying to look for some deer. And as it happened, as I was setting up, a group of four deer walked out in front of me about 75 yards away. Didn't really get any impressive shots, but at least I came to the right spot. So I've been sitting here for about 15 minutes now, trying to see if anything else might pass through, but they haven't yet. I'm kind of sitting in the ruts, so you can see that truck drove through this field, kind of created a nice spot to be able to watch. But it is just a beautiful morning. There's some milkweed in front of me. I was hoping that some birds might come through and get the seeds. They haven't yet. So I'm gonna sit for a little bit longer, see if anything shows up, and we'll see what we get. Well, fortunately, didn't have much luck with any other deer coming through or with any birds coming onto the milkweed there. So I'm just gonna move on and see if I can find anything else that looks interesting. Definitely a, there we go, now you can actually see me. It's definitely a field frequented by deer. There are deer tracks all over the place. And I can see hoof marks in the ruts, in the mud as well. So it's definitely a good spot to come back. Maybe I'll still find some more down as I go through the field. We'll see. There's a deer. About 50 feet to my right. Oh. just staring at me. I don't want to scare it. Oh, it just ran off. Oh, there's two of them. They both popped their head up out of the brush and they just took off. I don't think they went very far though. So let's see if we can just creep up down the trail a little bit. They went farther into the field. Spin this around here.
So they're back behind those trees somewhere in the taller brush. There's no real point in going in there. See if I can find them, because they're gonna hear me coming way before I get close to them. But that's good to know.
It's definitely a good spot to hang out underneath those trees. Looks like a good spot for them to bed down. Grass is all tamped down. I'm gonna continue on down this path and I'll leave them be, but that's good. So instead of going straight at the deer, I decided to stay on the path and loop around, because there is a path that goes along the outskirts of the field that I was going through on the tire tracks. So maybe this way I'll be able to get ahead of where the deer were likely heading, instead of scaring them and causing them to flee. Maybe this way I'll get ahead of them and they won't be as disturbed by my presence. But we'll see. There was kind of a high spot back there. You could kind of see into the field. And I did not see them, so they may have already come across where the four original deer that I had seen went, because they came over this direction somewhere. Leaves are very dry and crunchy, which makes it hard to walk quietly. Not to mention all the acorns on the ground. It doesn't look like I'm gonna have any luck. I don't see them through the tree layer over here. That's my right. And there's a pretty decent drop off to my left, where the four deer went. Probably a nice low spot down there that they hide out in during the day. But it was worth a shot. When it comes to wildlife like deer, I mean, it's almost impossible on conditions like this to sneak up on them, especially in an open field. I mean, that field, there was all sorts of tangles of vines and stuff. I would have made more noise going after them, and they would have just taken off. So there's no real point. I wouldn't have gotten any pictures. They would have been forced to flee. There's no point. It's a lose-lose. Just let them be. And maybe another day I'll be able to get there before they show up and get them. Continue on, see what I find. I'm going to switch gears now. I'm gonna go down to a pond. Typically has some ducks at it. It's gonna be a bit of a hike. So, hopefully there'll be something there. See what happens. There are two turkey vultures that just perched in an oak tree on the other side of this barn. I'm gonna try to get a shot of them. One landed right in front of me. Something moving right in front of me. There's a deer. In this tall grass right in front of me. I can hear it rustling. I just saw its ears perk up. Out over here.
see if it comes out onto the trail or not.
Alright, so I struck out with the deer. I think she decided to bed down in tall grass. I changed my position from behind the sign down into the field across the path because the wind was blowing my scent straight to her. But I don't think she's coming out. There's more cover in this tall grass than there is on the other side, so. It's a bummer. I was kind of hoping she was going to pop her head up so I could get a picture of her in the tall grass, but. Next time. So that was really cool. Never been able to get that close to a turkey vulture before, as it was just sitting in a tree. Usually they're on top of a building or just soaring in the sky. So it was nice to see one just on a nice perch nonetheless. And actually just kind of sit there and let it do its thing for a little while. Such an impressive bird. Oh, as I was saying before my GoPro kicked me off. Turkey vultures, they're such an important bird. They have such a good, important function for the ecosystem. And they don't get as much love as they deserve. So I was happy to be able to spend some time with that one. So I'm gonna keep going on to the pond now. See if there's anything down there. See if my luck continues this morning. About 50 yards in front of me, there is a deer. See if I can actually get a picture of it this time. Thank you. was able to get off trail a little bit and use that big oak tree as cover. And I just dropped my tripod down and just sat quietly. And the deer actually ended up walking straight towards me. I just stayed still, and it was probably within 15 yards of me before it realized that I was there. I think the wind shifted and it was able to smell me, and then it got on alert, saw me, and backed off. So I actually got a really nice shot of it. It ran maybe about 30 yards away and propped itself up on a hill and was just sitting there for about a minute and a half looking at me, trying to figure out what I was. And then it ended off trotting off along the tree line, probably into the field. But man, it's just an awesome experience. Awesome, awesome. I think that's gonna be it for me today. Came out looking for mammals, and I found some deer, so I'm happy with that. If nothing else, got some good photos and some experiences, and that'll be it. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you on the next adventure.